Hey there, guys. It's your favorite backyard geographer out in the garage, and I'm actually going through my minerals today. You know, often people ask, well, how do you identify minerals? And there's actually a lot of ways to do it, but the easiest is based off of its physical properties. We can look at a mineral's hardness, its color, its luster, its streak, and its cleavage. So let's learn how to identify minerals. So to begin with hardness, most of us, or scientists, have our hardness kits. So these hardness kits are numbered 1 through 9. In fact, our hardness for specimens go through 10, 1 being the softest, being talc, which you can easily scratch with a fingernail, and 10 being a diamond, which is the hardest that we have. This case does not have 10, but it does stop at 9, which is a corundum. To go through them very quickly, we have talc at 1, we have gypsum at number 2, and then about 2.5 is the strength of your fingernails, calcite at 3, we have fluorite at 4, apatite at 5, feldspar at 6, quartz at 7, topaz at 8, and corundum at number 9. And the way that this is done is you have your unknown specimen. I normally start with my number 4, and I take my number 4 and I scratch my specimen. If my number 4 scratches the unknown specimen, then my specimen must be softer. So then you move down to a number 3, and then I scratch again. When I find that they scratch each other, that means they're of equal hardness, so therefore this specimen would have a hardness of 3. The next one is color, and often in my classes I teach the fact that color, although the most obvious, is probably not the most helpful. Just as an example, if I pull out that fluorite again out of my box, these are both green specimens, but this one is not fluorite. So as you can see from some other specimens I'm working with today, so many different varieties of color. Again, they're the most obvious element because I can go, oh, well, this one's blue, and this is blue, and this is purple. But just because it's a certain color doesn't mean that it has to be that certain mineral. So we can certainly use it as more of a tool in the back of our minds. But again, color, the most obvious, but not the most helpful. The next physical property we have is luster, which is essentially how does it reflect or deal with light. So as we can see, again, this is very glassy, but maybe you have a specimen that's more metallic-y, or a specimen that might be a little bit more earthy in tone, or again, maybe really shiny. So these, you know, this is also metallic luster in itself, but these are all very different in how they appear with light. This is more like a glitter, yet this is more like a mirror. And in fact, those tools, those observations can also help narrow down what the specimen might be. Another physical property is streak, and often our cases here, a little hardness kits, will come with a streak plate, which is a white tile. And what we can do is by striking a sample along the streak plate itself, sometimes the streak will be of the same color. Sometimes it will be of a different color. And that is a great tool in order for us to identify what that specimen is. So as an example, I'm going to take this unknown specimen here, the one that's very glittery, and I'm going to, and as we can see, is also silver in color, and I'm going to strike it on my streak plate. So you do this one time. So the key, the reason I say you can only do it one time is because you're gonna make a streak on this tile. So the key is to be really aggressive with it. You're not gonna get crazy back and forth. You're gonna take it in the corner and drag it one time. And I'm gonna take kind of the glitter away and look at the color that's left behind. That's the genuine streak of that specimen. And although this specimen appears to be a different color, that's the streak, and that's what's going to help us identify. Just that alone tells me that this is hematite. So as we saw, this silver mineral made a dark red, brownish color streak on the plate, and that is a great tool for us to identify what that specimen would be. So another physical property we can look at is looking at the cleavage or fracture of a particular specimen. So as we can observe here, that many of these specimens that I have very unique crystalline shapes or patterns or designs. In fact, these little wood models here that I'm going to lay out in front, these all represent different types of crystalline structure that we can find in minerals. Now, when talking about cleavage or fracture, it's really just that. Cleavage is the way that the mineral breaks, and fracture is how it shatters. So if I were to take as an example, this silvery mineral here, this is a piece of galena, and I were to smash it, it would just break, it would fracture, but I can definitely see that it has a very distinct crystalline form. In fact, it looks very much like this wood block right here, right? I can also see that this piece of calcite, which is in a rhombus, is very similar to this wood block right here. But what's interesting about calcite is that it has cleavage, meaning that if I were to smash that piece of calcite, it would make a very special shape. One more idea here. This is also a piece of a mica. This has a very unique cleavage. It has one plane of cleavage, meaning it has a top and a bottom. So if I sit here and I peel away, it'll peel off into really thin sheets. So it has one perfect plane of cleavage. I love this one. This is a piece of lemon quartz. Very double terminal, meaning 2 points. Has not been colored, it was just this yellow in shape. Now, I mentioned this idea of how certain specimens might even break into a special shape, and I also referenced that calcite is one of those. So let's take a moment and let's smash a piece, not that one, that's a big one, we'll smash a smaller one, and we'll see what type of shape it makes. Now, if I take my hammer, my 4-pound hammer, and I smash a specimen, let's look at what happens when it breaks. So I'm gonna cover it so I don't get it on the camera. So I go, and look. It broke in half, but all it did was make a smaller shape of the exact same thing. I'll do it one more time for those in the back. Ready? Uh-oh. Look at that, all these itty-bitty little pieces, again, all rhombohedrals. It just makes smaller of the larger crystalline structure. So as you saw, that specimen smashed into much smaller rhombuses, rhombohedral shapes, which is really unique for that type of mineral. Another thing we can actually do also to help identify this, which doesn't deal with any of these physical properties, is we could drop hydrochloric acid. We would find that this piece of calcite would start to sizzle as well. But again, most of these minerals have really unique properties, things that make them very unique themselves. One more fun fact about calcite is that when you have a piece of clear calcite like this, it has a unique optical property, meaning that if I were to put it on a piece of text, like on this book that I have open right here, it would actually double the text. It would make a doubled image, and that's part of one of its optical properties. Well, I hope that was helpful to observe how we interpret minerals by looking at the hardness, the color, the luster, the streak, and the cleavage. Don't forget to click like, subscribe, and we'll talk soon.